Hello and welcome back to the show. So we're on to our final map with G2 versus Arcade, which is going to be Mirage. So I would say, is it that Arcade took us by surprise or that G2 are underperforming?
Both, I would say.
Both.
I think that's fair. It's not like, obviously, part of this lineup was Vega Squadron before. They've played versus Gamers 2, so Gamers 2 shouldn't be surprised by what they're going up against. They should know what kind of players they're playing up against. So I think it's not a case of G2 underestimating Arcade at all. I think it's more of them just not being able to perform. For the two first maps, I haven't really seen AZ do anything at all up to this point. And when you have a lineup or a team like G2, you kind of need people to perform well individually because you don't have that much to fall back on, which is kind of evident with how they play their T side on Dash.
Very quickly, Yanko, what are you expecting here? G2 or Arcade?
I'm going to say G2 still.
All right, let's see how it goes. We've got G2 heading towards the A site, it seems, with the bomb and the entire team. And there are three Arcade players in position, so they could potentially have a good read on this. Starting to move in now. Kashanda's playing the ninja spot and the bomb goes down. How many more can he get? Frag's going either way now and suddenly Mir is on his own versus three. I do believe Mir is the name of a Russian satellite. Also apparently means peace in Russian.
Isn't Mir the Russian space station?
Could be that as well. Something in space.
Up there in the stars. Well, maybe Mir will be claiming a spot up there if he can have this 1-on-3 go his way. But three players facing at once, not going to go his way. So Mir is going to be put in the ground for now. And here we go. We've got Arcade having lost that pistol round on a force buy.
It's pretty much the first time we've seen Arcade actually... Okay, Robin's apparently been kicked. Mid-game. Now, it seems like this is the first time we actually see Arcade not get off to a good start by winning the pistol. So maybe... it's going to be interesting to see how they can fight back from it if G2 are the ones to get off to a hot start.
You got the push here with Fox leading it through connector, which is nice. He's got AZ there to back off as well. So good forward positioning found here by the T side as they systematically claim the control of the bomb sites. Only one man lost so far in Fox. So job done for the G2 boys at the moment. However, three players left still with pistols and armor, so it could be a bit of a nuisance still. Three versus three, in fact, but no kits for the players of Arcade.
I think there's the better bomb plant for G2 as well, behind triple as opposed to the default one, which makes it a lot better for defense, as the default is not a good plant for the team to try and hold. Ooh, just too many people. Jacob stuck between two mines there. He could... Actually, I remember Steel giving me a grilling about trying to hold in that position. They don't have time. Okay.
But they killed everybody, and they picked up an AK and a P90.
Well, just that wall, that corner of that wall behind where Mir's facing right to your right. Like if you stand in that corner, then you've got yourself a 1v1 engagement rather than standing halfway between CPL and connector and being taken down by two CTs there. So a lot of damage done. I mean, G2 are lucky in the end to get away with that.
No, they really are, and well, a lot of armor. Actually, yeah, we can see Arcade they're buying up again. They're feeling hot right now, putting the pressure right on G2.
Yeah, this is a hot spot, isn't it? Because it does feel quite marginal. Do you make the call and force buy and kind of destroy your own economy potentially? Because they are going to go in with a disadvantage into this round. Or do you just save the weapons and try to do a bit more economic damage with the P90 and the AK?
I guess they know how much damage they did to G2, and they're going to get a better buy off of this round than what they had in the previous round. So I guess it's fair, actually. It's a completely viable decision to make from Arcade's point of view.
The whole opportunity cost dynamic.
Yeah, the only thing that irks me so far, obviously this could change once the pause goes out, even though JR could still buy. I would like to see... Okay, there we go. He buys a pistol at least. But I would like to see JR actually invest to it. If his entire team is committing this hard to a buy, it doesn't really matter if he's going to be able to buy an op in the upcoming round, unless they're just going to start playing a game of chicken with Gamers 2 and just force up until the point where they could be down 0-5 and not really have any sort of economy to look at. Okay, so he does go for the scout buy, which I'd like.
Okay, so let's see if G2 can hold. Fox taking a lot of damage there. Nice timing. There is a player creeping up towards Palace as well. Cody's going to get the frag onto McAlealy and one onto Jacob as well. Two P90 frags for him. All of a sudden, G2 have only Rain left.
I don't even know how that happened so quickly. Rain, it is Rain, but JR with the just jumping shots, shooting players down from the heavens themselves with that scout, and he's going to be able to finish things off. And they managed to pick up, they got another AK now, so that that worked out perfectly. And this is exactly what we're talking about. They're forcing the force out of G2 now. The game of chicken, as you said.
Yeah, and if they can win this, then it doesn't really matter the fact that they lost the pistol round. They're going to be off to a great start anyway.
Well, they're going to go for a fast short play. JR's saving for the AWP, so he's only got a P2000 to offer. Moving into a connector now, and Kashan's not going to get the close range P spray down. Losing players are the CT side. G2 still with strength in numbers, and now it's only HutG. What is going on, Dat?
I don't even know. I mean, honestly, there were a lot of spots there where Arcade, I think, they got a little bit panicked in how they should actually attack, like, hold those positions.
I think that it's greed. I liked how JR actually bought up with the scout in the previous round, so you can actually be full force. At this point, you would have to expect that G2 are actually going to force buy up, because that's what G2 does. So if JR actually has a rifle that he can work with in the middle there, he's going to be able to do so much more damage and play so much more aggressively and actually help out his team instead of just having to bail because he has a P2000 to play with.
That's a really good point, actually.
The force buys have ended, and Arcade will find themselves on the eco. Killing one player so far, and Mir may get taken down after that one dig. Indeed he will. So maybe somewhat of a normal round will resume. AWP finally comes out for JR, but at what cost? It's 1-4 versus G2.
I can see Kashander also only sitting on 3.4. She's not going to have the greatest of buys either. He's going to have to get a FAMAS. And actually gets full Kevlar instead of nades, which is somewhat surprising to me. But I guess, he's going aggressive, so he's not going to have too much use for nades.
JR getting a super fast pick onto Makalele. Kashander cannot escape in time. That pop flash going to wreck him. 4 versus 4 now. CPL has been smoked off, so JR's going to have to reposition. There's a two-man push, though, from B, and Fox is headed that way with the bomb. But, he's turned around just in time, thanks to that frag by Rain. If he doesn't get that frag, maybe G2 lose the round there.
Yeah, let's see if that is still a possibility. JR's in position with the AWP. He's not being flanked just yet, so he can get some one-on-one engagements. But AT, superior positioning towards connector, dropping both players. JR will slow things down just ever so slightly before being eliminated. So the bomb goes down just right at the end for an extra $300 for that player.
That could have been a catastrophe.
Yeah, and the thing that Vendetta was saying as well about the greed, and just, how he just having the rifle there would be much better than what he had. So the situation on the CT side, you're always more scared for your economy on this map than you are on the T side. So yeah, it's kind of a shame they weren't thinking about their economy a little bit more.
And the problem is that now G2 is going to go, or probably going to get up to 6 rounds before Arcade are even going to get a really proper buy. They haven't really had a superb buy as up to this point.
Not much going on here for the Arcade team. They've got 2 kills in fairness. The bomb is left in a passive position and G2 are quite spread out, so that's going to be a bit of a pain. You see McAlealy there is going to have to go and retrieve the bomb, but those two frags are going to make things very easy for him. He can just rotate through T-spawn. Being careful though, just in case the last CT is in a sneaky position, and that rotation will now come in. So Hutchie has potential because he's only got 6 HP here, and he has got a 1v1 engagement, but it's very awkward. He will get the shot that he needed. We'll see what he opts to. What? What is that? Rain goes down. It's just McAlealy now versus HutG. This is. Are you serious? This is not. What is this?
I don't know. This is quite impressive, though. If HutG can actually finish this one off, he's looking for the angle. Oh, he gets tagged there through the step. HutG moving in for the kill now, though. This is getting really tense. McAlealy knows just one shot is all it takes. And surely he can't hold here with no kit, but he is. And that's going to be that. McAlealy takes the frag, and it was very scary, but G2 will win the round, but they lost almost everybody, so that's actually really huge. It's going to help out Arcade a lot.
Yeah, it's going to be a could make a big difference going further on into this game. If G2 were to get a bomb plant here, they should still be fine. Actually, they could, being G2, they could still probably buy up with Tech-9s and AKs, but this is a big round for Arcade. I think they need this if they want to have a shot.
Well, JR has started off well again. Reigns up close. He's going to use that smoke to his advantage. Coming in quickly, but JR's going to take him down as well. That Connector in control by CT for the moment. But G2 moving into Connector now. Hachi taking down Fox elsewhere. 4 versus 2. Bomb moves in Connector, but they won't be able to defend from short and A at the same time. Or will they? AZ getting the frag onto short, with Jacob taking the frag onto A, but now it's AZ versus 2. Ooh, JR's missed a shot now. That gives AZ some opportunity, but he's messed up his first flashbang. Gets the second one and flashes himself. Manages to get over to CT, and he'll get a successful bomb plant because no one's over there.
There is an incendiary, though, for Hachi, so he can use that to force AZ out of position, but good timely peek. There will be the end of JR finally, and AZ's going to clutch it down for the team. So AZ turns up in this round. But that round was very risky from G2. They took one-on-one after one-on-one after one-on-one. There was no trade game there from them.
Yeah, absolutely. That's very true. And I guess that goes down to G2 actually being extremely confident now, yeah.
Five Molotovs for the G2 side on the Antico. Makes me happy.
Not going to use them, though.
Not going to use them, of course. Just going to rush into the site.
This is something that's going to trigger Yanko.
Yeah.
I think it triggers a lot of people, actually.
Marvelous.
Oh, it works out, I guess. But yeah, no, weird to... You buy 5 Molotovs, you don't use a single one.
I guess if someone has a good spawn to get a fast pick towards A, then they can... well, who knows? I don't know. I'll leave that to Yanko rather than me. 8-1 now in favor of G2, so looking for a stomping first half to the last game of this best of three. Okay, back on the buy. We've seen JR do considerable damage. Will he get into the spawn fast enough? Well, he's not going to be challenged. G2 going back into rush mode, perhaps all heading over towards B. Are they going for a contact play?
Yeah, they're looking for something a little bit different than some of the usual rounds they've been going with. And perhaps it can work out here. We've got Mirror in a really nice position on the site. He's going to spot Ace. He's just looking for the head there, but won't spot it. It's going to be Jake, and he gets taken down from the back. But Michael Lillia wrapping around is going to find the refrag, and it's a game of retakes here for Arcade as the bomb goes down. And there are still 3 Molotovs and a couple of smokes left here for G2, and they're beginning to finally use them. But will they be successful here? Got a bit of an engagement here towards short that Fox is going to take down, and you would think that that's going to really hamstring the efforts here, that Arcade are pretty much done, and indeed they're going to back away.
All over the place now is the CT economy, and you have to wonder if Arcade are starting to get concerned. Can they keep their metal here? Both heavily tagged, and what's going on here? Can't get the wall bang in time, but G2 won't be too worried. 9-1. Arcade could get shut out this in one half.
And for me, it all comes down to the opening rounds where they decide to force play, and then eventually the greed getting the better of them. It just sends them into such a deep hole that they're not able to climb out of.
An avalanche of despair.
Yeah.
Well, there we go. We got a potential for Arcade to bring themselves a few more rounds back still, of course. Something to work with, perhaps. And we've got the aggression coming in from G2 on middle, and they do seem pretty strong at taking these mid battles. Another positive result there. Shanda looking to hold things down here in Connector, and that's actually looking like it's working out. The bomb is going to go down. 3 versus 3 now. Mirror also helping out there just a little bit before dying. And now Rain has the opportunity to get out of Palace, potentially, as there's only 3 CTs left.
Yeah, but he has no idea if anybody is below him, but he's going to identify with a pop flash. Looking for any movement from the CT, and he doesn't see anything yet. So this is quite an interesting situation. But Rain has limited time. What a peak there. Now he knows that there's somebody in shadow as well. Coming out and takes him down. Rain, absolutely insane. Leaving Hachi wondering what could have been.
Yeah, indeed. I have to see if he can pull something out the back here, but that first frag of Rain seems a little bit so gratuitous. As here we go. Hachi goes for it. Yeah, when that smoke goes down, you gotta, I mean, if you think about it, what is the purpose for Rain to throw a smoke there as a T player? He's gotta be using it to either move out
or I'm doing in that situation versus Rain is getting wrecked.
I guess my point is that the guy that got killed first, I feel like he's a little bit too exposed. Like he didn't expect anything from there.
I guess he questions whether, what side Rain's going to come out on.
Well, another fast play from G2, storming the A site, 3 kills. This is a buy, make no mistake, for Arcade. And Everybody's getting ranked, and now they can throw the Molotovs down. Hunty again on the B side. Oh no, he's the B player. The hunt is beginning. G2 just playing the rush, as they say in poker.
G2 are playing way better than what they did on Cash, and you can tell that they're actually hitting their shots this time around. You can see AZ is actually showing up this game, and it makes G2 a completely different beast. But still, this is kind of an opposite situation where we found ourselves on Cash, where it was Arcade that found the small margins, and they were the ones to get off to a good start and find the right timings. Now it's G2 just doing the exact same to Arcade.
And I've seen that happen before in this map quite often as well, when the CTs play a gambly style at the start of the map. And we actually kind of saw that. We saw some gambles there by Arcade.
Yeah.
You've got to look after that economy. You've got to nurture it. And they didn't put the attention there.
Right, Fox off to a good start. Not. He got killed by JR in mid. There's not much utility on the Arcade side here. 5-5 matches, not many grenades going on. But Makalele is being charged by the balls on the Arcade side. The bomb's been lost now, so Arcade could double their score. But is it all too late here with G2 on 11 rounds and Arcade on just the one?
Well, it is Rain, isn't it? One of the smartest clutches in the game. And he's going to find himself a couple more engagements. Just tapping away. 3 kills for Rain now. And it's hard to even be surprised when Rain pulls out results like this. However, 2 more players to find. The bomb to be picked up as well. He's got a minute to play with, so he has time. He's got health and grenades as well to play with. See if he can work out the best approach here, and he's going to get caught off guard there, JR from below. It was a good attempt from Rain, though, with three kills. That's definitely going to weigh on Arcade, because they could have picked up a lot of guns there, which would have been excellent for them.
Yeah, still having to rock 3 for Mosses. Few nades to work with, but not really sure if that's going to have too much of an impact with the way G2 are playing right now, because I think they're in a mode where they're just going to run through everything.
Okay, so we've got max nades on the T side again. Varies on the Arcade team. Rain is causing them more problems, but he's going to get traded around the palace area. The bomb is headed towards B, though. Still 2 players there. Got that sneaky position on the wooden panels there, but Mir's going to take things down and get traded himself, so no space stations to hit. JR holding things down in mid area. A man advantage now for Arcade. Not sure if they've spotted the bomb in B apartment. There is a play coming in from short. Meanwhile, Jacob's looking to cause some shenanigans over towards A. Is that going to pull a rotation?
2-on-2. And this is very nice for G2, this kind of situation. When you've got a minute left, you can see that Jacob's in an excellent position where he can get a lot of free information. He can deny these choke points away from the CTs as well onto the A site. He's making a lot of noise, which is likely or could very well have been heard by Hunchy. But Jacob, he is the vanguard of the A bomb site right now. And he's going to allow the free plant from Makalele. And in comes Arcade now that they've worked out what's going on. But they're going to have to hit some extraordinary shots to pull this out of the bag. And it's Makalele to just stop the hope. The Russian hope is now being quelled. Just 1 player left. JR, 12 HP, going in for it now. But Makalele finds the kill. So pretty well played out there by G2.
I think those nades were for Yanko and Vendetta. Did the Molotov guys?
I was waiting for the entire time for Jacob to close off one of the areas or something while Makalele makes it onto site. You know, Jacob's just holding onto it.
Well, we're into the last round of the first half now. But again, nice play there by Rain, just doing crazy Rain things. Mir's been spotted going into the underpass. What is this play now? They've only got pistols here on the CT side. They are taking down Rain in the trade again. But that trade's going to favor the T's.
A smart pre-fire there from Fox through the smoke, expecting him to double back. And indeed, that was the play. And still, some frags going the way of Arcade. But 2 more players to take down if they want to steal this one away. And they would definitely need at least 3 rounds to be have any chance at all in the next half. But looks like it's going to be denied largely. Although Hutchie should be able to get a free frag here. And indeed, there it is. Bomb goes down as well.
4x3.
And potentially, yeah. Maybe he can pick up a weapon. But no, it looks like it might not be happening here for him. 1-on-1 now.
Well, Jacob knows he's in ladder room based on the vents being shot, so he's going to go for a very quick plant towards CT. An open one as well, so he can defend it from T slope should he choose to go there. And he is heading for fireboxes, so we'll see what Hachi can do here. He's got a 5-7, and that's about it. No kits, no anything else. Jacob slowly creeping around, and this is all very interesting. See what Hachi is trying to eliminate now, facing the other way, looking for opening. He's going to get a frag as well. So Arcade will get 3 rounds on their CT side. Not great by any means.
No, absolutely not. It's going to be pretty hard indeed. At least they get three, though. I mean, that's... I mean, three is like the minimum where, okay, we still don't have a chance, but...
Yeah, at least we have a cushion.
At least there is. At least if we lose the pistol round, we can still maybe have it do something in the game, basically. Yeah. That's the idea.
Well, that's really what this game is all about. They have to win the pistol round. And, well, setting up for an A take here. Two smokes on JR and Cassander, so most likely going to be smoking off spawn and towards jungle, I would assume. Here we go.
Can it be good? We got players of RK making their way into the A sites, and they are swarming it at the moment. AZ's in amongst them. They this don't know about him.
Really cool. They've actually pushed into jungle here.
And AZ's play goes for naught. So here comes Rain now from pit. He's got a player on his angle. Cassander will go down. And all the frags going the way of G2 out of nowhere. All of a sudden, the bomb is ticking away, but just Mir left against all these players. He's got the Tech 9 as well, and he's been pinned down at this point. You can see that they're not going for the defuse attempt just yet, but now is the time for GT to make that happen. And they're both going to try to face Mir. Can he handle it? No. And they will be fine for the defuse. So it looks like G2 are going to have a fast one, or very likely will have a fast win here.
Yep, not the dream scenario. I do like the strategy being pulled up by Arcade though. Pushing two people in towards jungle right there is gonna give them a lot of room to work with, especially with the plant that they get down towards the link or connector area. So they can play after plants pretty safely as well in most cases, but the rotation from G2 coming through connector and basically the backside from Rain really ruins everything for them.
Jacob's got the auto shotty heading over towards the B site. We know Fur has made it famous over towards T ramp on A. But is viable from the position he's holding as well. And he's got a player in position to throw a flash for him. We'll see how many he manages to get. One so far, and he's going to die a bit too early. There, Blue is loading, they were too far away. See if Arcade continues to push onto the site here. They're stuck in the choke points in the window, but the frags are going either way. Makalele coming in now, dancing around the smoke, not really seeing much. Maybe expecting players to be on the site already, but they're just starting to jump in now. All the CTs are on the site now. AZ coming in from short, and the numbers are running out for Arcade. Hutchie alone versus two. He's done some serious things in this situation before, but he's losing the angles there. Makalele to finish him off. 14-3.
So expensive into eco from G2, but still they get the round, and with that full investment from Arcade, that's not a lot they can actually do. I'm actually surprised if they're not going to force by here, and they are. So armor eagles actually not. Buying up with the Kevlar on everyone?
It's a very late buy, just to mess with you.
Oh, there we go, yeah.
Well, I don't even think Hutch ended up getting any. Yeah, so he's not buying armor for some reason.
Very strange. Well, I guess, you know, they're looking to win the match, and they're kind of assuming, okay, we're going to win this round, potentially. So, I don't know about the logic, really, but...
You're doing your best, but...
We'll have to see.
It's not going down. What is going down though is the numbers of Arcade here, and now the numbers of G2 as well, but G2 will still have the control over the rifles for the time being. Arcade getting closer, more deagles coming in now, down to a 2 versus 1. The carnage in this round, I don't even know. Rain is in towards the connector area. I'm not sure if they will hear him from the position. Doesn't seem they will. Again, all the rifles are on the wrong side of that connector for the T's, and they're starting to back away from mid. Hutchie potentially, let's see, seems to be going towards the B site as opposed to the A site. Rain won't spot the arc of that nade. So, still with some unknowns, and the deagle will finish him off. Another of just a few rounds here for Arcade.
Well, they do reset G2 at the very least, I guess.
Yeah, they did. Something positive. D2 playing that kind of carelessly. If I'm honest, just running in trying to see if they can pick up frags, and JR just keep continuously punish them. So that does give Arcade a... tiny bit of a chance to get back into this.
All right, so G2 again on the well, they've gone for a buy with pistols and armor. Ooh, some nice damage done there. Did he get two? Makalele gets one. He's going to get traded. Three CTs remaining. We've got a crossfire towards connector, but it's going to be the 1 versus 1. The trade coming in for Rain. There is a player on the chair position, also known as Delphan, and CT as well. So Rain trying to do what he can, but all he can do is die. Jacob, last man standing, now on the floor as well. And Arcade get another round on the board. What is the money here for G2? After going for the force, they're going to have to force to eco. They will be forced to eco. Do I even English?
I'm one of myself sometimes, James. After some of the things that we've said. But, yeah, 14 to 5, and we'll see G2 just going for the mid plate. This is going to be spamming all those USPs down middle. It's a beautiful arrangement of CTs with USPs. But unfortunately, don't know that they'll get too much out of this.
I like the braveness in JR at least.
Yeah.
It's like sees five people, takes on five people.
Well, he's a Russian, I think, right? So.
I think he's Ukrainian.
Is he a Ukrainian player? Well. He's got so much.
What are you doing,
bravery.
Dan? What are you doing?
I'm saying he's got bravery.
Two G2 players left. They both picked up AKs. Let's see if they choose to go for this. There's a triangle of doom around the bomb site now, and down goes Rain. EZ will be shot through the smoke. He'll be executed. He is gone.
And he is indeed Ukrainian. My mistake. I think there's three Russians, I think, on the lineup. All right, so Arcade Esports, they have some hope, and they showed pretty decent composure in some of the past maps as well. So looking to see what JR can get done with the AWP. It's been a while since we've seen JR really on this AWP, and that seemed incredibly pivotal, as Fox is so pivotal here, and we might just see this on the G2 side as he looks for the peaks on middle. And there it is. First frag going the way of JR, picking up AZ. Now again, this is a situation on the first level of Inferno that they played really well, the early advantage. But it will be evened up by Rain pretty quickly. G2 really want to get aggressive a lot of the time. It's almost unrelenting.
Two players on short for Arcade, who have the man disadvantage. But again, the bomb is far back, which makes things a little bit awkward for them. Seems that we've got a player looking for picks. Instant trade. Fox taking down Mir and JR taking down Fox. But again, now it's just down to JR. And he's going to collect the bomb. He's got 48 seconds to do something to try and find himself some one versus ones. McNally's coming in from short. Who's going to win this duel? There it is. G2 with match point now. 9 match points indeed.
I feel like that round was a good kind of example as to how G2 have been doing so well, especially on Mirage. Even if there's opportunity, G2 just they're hitting all their shots and they just have no fear at all. And if we're talking about JR not having fear in that situation on middle, G2 are the very epitome of that mentality at the moment.
Well, Arcade with four players over towards the A bomb site now, and AZ off to a good start. We'll see if G2 can hold as AZ make. Could get taken down in isolation. That nade, is it going to do much damage? It's going to do a fair chunk onto Cassandra. There's a gap in the smoke, but it's not going to pay off for AZ. Going to be a warning sign, though. You may have seen two players there. We've got a pop flash coming in from Rain, but the push has not started yet for Arcade.
Problem for Arcade right now is the fact that they're getting chunked down pretty heavily before they even get towards the bomb site. So I think they're going to have to try to find a pick before they actually go anywhere.
Here we go, Rain. Once again, we're talking about that aggression. And there it is. Not giving a damn. It's pushing forwards. And JR just trying to bunny in there, and it's not going to pan out at all. Looks like Arcade are on their last.
You could say Danny bunnied into the motorway and got run over.
Yeah, well, Hutchie is looking to try to save this one versus four. Two AWPs in play. And Fox is just going to walk in there and take him down. So 16-6. It was a nice run. But it appears that G2 has set things right.
Yeah.
Yanko, what Rain. Went wrong there?
Rain and AZ decided that Arcade is not gonna pass further into the tournament. They just showed up completely on their T side. They did basically the same stuff they tried on Cash, just fast executes, running out of A slope, middle, wherever. This time around, they got all the entry kills and all the trades, and you can see how calm Rain was even in that 1v4, I think it was, with those insane taps. His aim was just so on point, and it shows how G2, how they are as a team, how they can be dangerous when two of their individual, two of their five players step up individually. They just take the whole game over by themselves.
Well, Halvor, anything to add?
No, that's really what happened, and we said it during the game as well. This is just the opposite of what we saw in Cash, pretty much from G2. They're finding the timings, they're hitting their shots, and when G2 actually do that, they're incredibly hard to stop. Doesn't really help the fact that Rain was just playing out of his mind, and even when G2 didn't have the initial luck in a round, then he would be able to bring it back for them as well.
Yeah, I mean, it seemed like also in the first two maps,
this shot was back.
Arcade were able to start on essentially their better side on both maps, getting them off to a good start each time. And it felt like on Mirage there, that just did not happen for them at all. G2 able to just completely shut them down from the first half. They couldn't find the comfort there at all. And without that comfort zone, they couldn't get their individual skill going. And then we saw much less duels won by them. I know we had slightly better performances from G2, but it shouldn't have been that. The disparity was not that huge if you take the performance from map 1 and 2 from the arcade players.
I think a lot of it comes down to the fact that, yeah, I think we can agree that arcade played worse on Mirage than what they did on the previous two maps, but as well as G2 playing better on Mirage than what they did in the first two maps. But for me, the big thing as to what really ruined the game for arcade was the greediness. And after finally winning the chicken duel between four spies versus G2, they opt to go easy on them when G2 are obviously going to force buy, and they lose that round. After that, they have no way of coming back into it. They're left in this deep hole with no money, and G2 just have an immense amount of time to just build up their economy. And G2 doesn't even really need that much of an economy on their T side to be extremely dangerous, as we saw, hence why they won their force buy with the Tech Nines. So for me, Arcade kind of shot themselves in the foot early on the CT side, and if you want JR to be as effective as possible, you need to give him that off. Not that he played a really good game regardless, even though his team didn't get that many rounds, he was at 25 plus frags. But if you want him to be as effective as possible and potentially dictate how the game is played and kind of force D2 into not going into middle as often and all that stuff, and maybe even use their nades, as weird as that sounds for G2, you're going to have control of your economy early on, and I think they screwed themselves over in that way.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Well, our next match is going to be CSGO Lounge versus Mouse, a team who have just kicked their captain. Gobby has left the building. He's being replaced by Spilly. So we'll get into that in about 25 minutes. In the meantime, we'll be on a break. We'll see you back here at the top of the hour for the next match.